What's up, fellas? I hope you are ready for your long daily dose of skill. Happy weekend, by the way. Today, we are going to do a very long tech tree showcase. Listen, a lot of you voted for a trash barn, so here you go, you are going to get it, right? But listen, this tech tree will look like this. Since there is two ways to go to this tech tree, I'm going to do it. I will start everything with a Sherman and Firefly, so one battle each tank. After that, I will move down to Archer, a Hill, Challenger, probably a couple of games with this, couple of games with a Charioteer, couple of games with a Convoy, and like 2-3 battles with a Fava Trashburn. So this Tech 3 showcase is going to be roughly 2 hours, I'm not sure. I am, like I said before, I am reading your comments, and a lot of you requested to get a couple of battles with a tier 10 tank and to talk more about it, so I will try to do everything what I can, fellas. And also, I just wonder, maybe I should do a video about what tanks currently is the best and worth to grind for, and which tank is a trash, at least in my opinion. Like, three sections of the tanks, like trash, okayish, and good. Maybe I should do video like this, and maybe you could skip, you don't need to watch every single Tech 3 showcase, and I could talk about those vehicles. That could be smart, right? So, if you want to see this, obviously feel free to comment down below, or feel free to like whatever's comment if you agree with that idea, right? So without talking too much, I believe we can start everything. Also, I'm quite curious how the blueprints is going to work for me, since I have every single vehicle researched, so, you know, it is going to be quite interesting stuff, I believe. One or another way, fellas, see you in a minute and we will start our journey, right? Okay, fellas, we are ready to go. Listen, now this vehicle have quite some guns to offer, right? If you would go over there, the two options which I see right there is a Derp gun over there. Skill, move your face from here. Okay, so first of all, this is this gun, right? And we have the gun of the we have a 76mm gun, right? So it's completely up to you, what do you prefer? Both of them could work and both of them is fine. 76mm gun is better for sniping, and Derp gun is just better when you are, let's say like that, a bottom tier or something. Anyways, I am not going to play with a Derp gun with this tank, I don't really think it's worth it, and I will play with this 76mm gun, right? We are going to test it out. Oh, very interesting, AP as a gold. Well, we will test it out, right? We don't have a super good crew, but hey, at least our radio operator is quite skilled, so let's go into the battle, right? I am very, very curious, and once again, fellas, do you want to go to that line? It is completely up to you. For me, both of the ways is looking pretty much fine, because grind to Valentin is pain in the ass, grind to the Grand probably it's pain in the ass, so I don't even know, it's completely up to you. But in the same time, when I'm looking into this line, right, I am seeing quite weird stuff. I think British tanks is missing another line right there, but hey, once again, maybe it's only me. Without talking too much, let's start our journey. Clap clap, let's go. Also, fellas, I see a lot of comments of yours. Hey, skill, how to get Mark of Excellence mod, fellas? How you can do that? All you need to do, you need to go into the Google, right? Type in the Google Mark of Excellence mod in the current version of the game. Currently, we have 1.4.1, and you can add in then Spotter, because Spotter is the guy who created this mod pack. And the funniest thing of all this, This person even added my name in their mod pack, like this kind of setup, and it's called by my name. It's very, very kind of him, and thank you. Okay, boys, what we are going to do in this game? Obviously, we are bottom tier, and sometimes stuff like this is happening. Can I make my face tiny touch bigger? I just wonder. Uno momento. Skill, we need to see your face. Mwah. Okay. I hope it's not going to be too big. If so, I apologize. How do I dare? Okay, very good. So what do we want to do in this game? I believe, first of all, we are going to start the game from this position over there. Hopefully, we are going to spot people which is crossing like this. Fingers crossed. That's what I hope for. And, you know, with majority of the tier 7s in that kind of matchmaking against the 2 tiers higher, let's get real, you cannot do too much, right? This is the worst thing of all this, but in the same time I am not complaining. There is a pixel shot which we missed, and I could wait for a second longer, then I could punish this guy, but I am not complaining. Can we track him? That was perfectly into the tracks, and probably we damaged his fuel tank, but yeah. I think this guy just realized that he is doomed, right? Fire! I knew it, we damaged his fuel tanks, okay? You know what? I believe we can make a bit of pressure like this. Hopefully it's going to be a good idea and I'm not going to regret this afterwards. At least I hope so, right? And once again, as a being bottom tier, I should be tiny touch more careful right here. I should not play like crazy, you know. I should not make too much pressure. And it goes not only for me, it goes for you too. Also about the echo which I mentioned before, fellas, in the room, right? Because if I will talk louder, you can hear echo pretty much, right? So, I ordered materials, I have the numbers and everything, and it's going to arrive in the after maximum 1 month. From 1 week to 1 month, right? This is the stuff when we should get this those materials. And hopefully, sound quality is going to be way better. I know microphone is over there, and maybe I will get a microphone stand in the future, which is going to hopefully be good. Okay, guys, if we are speaking about the speed of this vehicle, it's definitely not a bad speed or something. Unfortunately, enemies had literally no team and we have only a couple of shots, but maybe we will save the game right now. How we can save the game? We are just moving in front like crazy, right? And we are trying to get some assisting damage from the people over there. And this is my plan, and hopefully we are going to have a decent ending right there, right? That's what I want to believe, and that's what I am going for. By the way, that Stuck was playing dead, or he is a bot. And by saying he's a bot, I don't want to offend him, don't get me wrong. This is how bots is reacting. They are AFK for majority of the game, and after that, when they are spotting someone by themselves, right, they are starting to move and do the things in front, right? And they are starting to shooting. So don't get me wrong, I do not want to insult that person. He simply was acting like a bot. That's it. So yeah, fellas, that was the game with a tier... That was the game with a tier 5 against the tier 7s. I don't think this battle was bad. I think it was fine game. We got the end game damage right there, and we did pretty much everything properly. The thing is, when you have this kind of matchmaking, you can't say and go in front like this. You cannot. Otherwise, you are going to take one for the team and it's going to be end of the story, right? So I would highly recommend to not do so. First of all, try to play safer. After that, just simply try to get the end game damage, assisting damage, or whatever. Ally just killed P43, hashtag never lucky. That kind of stuff is happening sometimes, right? And in this certain situation, as you can see, enemies had no team. But once again, fellas, Sherman tier 5, I don't think it is a bad tank by any means. I think it's okay vehicle, it could be better, but you know, it is not a big deal. Everything is fine. Oh, what we are getting, what kind of blueprints we are getting. Oh, since I have everything researched, I'm going to get universal fragments all the time. Oh, this is going to be very, very good thing then. So, very nice. We're gaming, I like this blueprint things. Very, very nice. Okay, let's go with other vehicle. We are done with our tier 5 and tier 6 is going to be this one. Okay, we are going to come back right after a second. I need to pimp everything up and I need to check what I want to use on this vehicle. So see you in a second, fellas. And it is about the time to play with a Sherman Firefly. I definitely did not had a bad game with it before, definitely not, everything is fine. No one of you noticed that anyways. Good, so let's talk about the Sherman. There is two options what kind of stuff to use on this tank: optics, rimmer, and binos, or you can replace binos for vertical stabilizer, but then you are going to have only 425 meters view range if you are using the extra ration. So keep that in mind if you have 100% crew too. Without further ado, one more thing which I forgot: gun up on this tank. I would highly recommend to get this gun. Very good penetration, nice alpha damage, everything is looking fine with this tank. So let's go into the battle and hopefully this time we are going to have better battle experience. The thing is, in the last game I was the one who messed up. I went in front too aggressively since it was only tier 6 matchmaking, and then what, it was boom 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 boom, I took one for the team and you know, I cried in the corner. Sometimes stuff like this is happening, so it's fine. Also, fellas, Mark of Excellence mod is broken now. I mean, when you are playing with a tank for first couple of battles, Mark of Excellence mod is not very accurate, so keep that in mind. Also, if you are wondering why my cat was over there, I fed her over there. I gave her some treats, so I was expecting she is going to sit there. Unfortunately, that was not the case, okay? At least I give it a go, okay? Don't say anything. Anyways, this is a tier 8 battle. We are bottom tier, 357 matchmaking. Not much what we can do about that. I believe, fellas, the best way to play this battle for us is going to be to not go into the city. Why not go into the city? Usually I like to play there quite aggressive, right? But I think it's way too risky for this. I am feeling like it is way, way, way too risky. And this guy, he might try to do something. Maybe he's going to push in front. Maybe he's going to retreat. It doesn't matter. Whatever this guy is going to do, I want to punish him for his mistake, right? And right there, as you can see, we are bottom tier once again. And it's okay, I'm not complaining about that. For me, it is not a big deal. And I am kind of used to that already. Blind shot into the 12T, not a hit. Another blind shot, that was a hit. Maybe one more blind shot. Yes, baby, that was not a hit. You know what? I am going to go with the blind shots for that guy. Maybe I'm going to dig him out of there. You never know. And this time he have quite some ammunition, so I don't mind. Also, if we are speaking about that LTG, let's get real. I cannot go for that LTG just to kill him. I would love to, but it's way, 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 way more complicated than you might think. Because if I will go like this on this guy, those sniper schnitzels over there, they can hit us. And it's not bueno. So, the life of the bottom tier, fellas. You need to try to play smart. And simply try to punish enemies for their mistakes. For example, this person, he made a mistake. Let's get real. He's pretty much dead meat. He's not going to survive this. Kava 2 just sent him to the garage and not much what he can do. Same thing could be for me. If I am going to be too aggressive in this certain situation, it's just going to be game over. So, unfortunately, I cannot afford that, right? One of the shitter things over there is the main battle is happening over there, right? By the way, do you see this Cromwell? He could be a bot. If I will touch him and he will start moving, this could be a bot. No, unfortunately, well, maybe fortunately, this guy is... It's just a fucker, right? Maybe he's going for his cigarette, or maybe his mother called him for a dinner, or maybe his wife is saying, "Wee!" Also could be possibility, right? Also could be possibility. And right there, fellas, look, we are trying to get the side shots. Obviously, Ruski light tank is not the easiest tank to penetrate, so we are pretending it never happened. And maybe if I will push tiny touch more in front over there, hopefully everything will go well and maybe we will have a better angle. Unfortunately, it's not the case. That's not the best thing, right? Fellas, look, our EBR... Speechless. Our BR tried to rush on this guy, that did not work it very well, now it is my turn. I am going to hit him once again and then I will ram him. Good, and that's how we are getting our kamikaze. Easy, easy. So far 800 done, not the best score so far, but in the same time I cannot be too aggressive because I might pay a price for my stupidity. So I would rather play safe. And I will try to figure out, is it worth it to do one or another thing, or it's not worth it. For example, this IS, he's in the open field for us. So what we are going to do for us, we are going to farm him. Actually, he's dead already, since our cover 2 is pushing aggressively, right? And if I need to bet what this Ruski light is doing, he's already somewhere over there or alternatively there, right? So, yeah, that makes sense. So, Firefly, fellas. In my opinion, this is a sniper schnitzel in the... If you are a bottom tier, right? And if you are a top tier, you can't play too aggressively either. Why so? You know T-3485, right? That vehicle is pretty much good at everything. Good at sniping, good at whatever. This vehicle is not even close for that. You need to use your gun in order to get maximum use, right? And since you don't have any armor whatsoever, you might get punished for your mistakes, right? For example, that was a perfect thing from our side. We was waiting until this light is going to peak, he peak and we punished him. End of the story. That's the stuff which we want to do with this tank, right? This is exactly the stuff which we want to do with this tank. The worst thing of all this is this Ruski light. He have zero Fs given and this is mistake from my side. Look, he is just... peeking and just hitting me. Not much what I can do about that, but now I am simply aiming for this guy and hopefully he's going to make one or another mistake. I sacrificed way too many health for this guy, but I am not complaining. It is 1.2000 damage already. Yes, it's not the greatest battle in the world of tanks, fellas. But you cannot have every single game, which is, you know, when you are getting ace wankers or something. It's just not happening like this, right? And now, also fellas, keep that in mind. Our game is not even close for being over, right? We can try to farm this guy over there or alternatively that Skoda, right? It's fine, as you can see, we are just punishing this person. and not much what this guy could do. And now this guy is... I was about to click, but I was talking too much. It's okay. Not a big deal. 1.6 thousand damage, 300 assisting damage. I think we played this battle well. And even though this is not the best score ever in World of Tanks, it's not the worst score either. And I believe it is a roughly average game, at least for me with this vehicle. So everything was done properly and good. And the most importantly, we got our kamikaze. Everything is fine. Good. Kamikaze achieved. Life is beautiful. Very, 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 very nice, right? Okay, guys. So now, what we are going to do next? As you can see, we are done with those two vehicles over there. In my opinion, both of them is playable and everything is fine. And since they are leading to the trash burn line, I decided to play with them. Now we are going to start playing with Archer, Achilles, Challenger, Charioteer, Conway, and Favaz. So, like I said, this Tech 3 showcase is going to be longer than usual, but hey, I am not complaining and I am enjoying this stuff. Let me prepare Archer for everything and we will continue this in a second. And fellas, it is about the time to play with Archer. Very, very bizarre tank, or however to spell that properly, weird tank, right? Because of one reason, you are moving frontwards on 12 kilometers per hour, backwards 32. I know it's weird, and this is the tank which is unique just because of that. And I would never ever say, fellas, I would never ever say this vehicle is bad by any means. In my opinion, it's quite decent, it's quite good, and it's unique in a way, right? There is no other tank which is moving faster backwards than frontwards. So this is the thing to keep in mind. And how to play with Archer in general? Well, there is only one way how to play with Archer in general. You are taking the bush, you are saying, this is my home, and you are sitting in this bush forever and ever. In other words, you can take yourself a newspaper, you can open it and you can read it like this while you are sitting in the bush, if enemies are not making any mistakes, right? For example, in this battle, we are going to take this bush over there, right? Right over there, right? And we are going to sit here pretty much forever. I can imagine some people dislike that kind of gameplay and then go for a medium tanks, right? At least that's what I assume. Sorry if I'm yawning, fellas. I had very, very hard training today, so you know, it is understandable why I am tired a bit, right? It is understandable. Okay, this guy. Look, we are waiting until he's going to make one or another mistake. That's it. I mean, can I hit him? Unfortunately, I cannot. I think he should be disconnected or something. Pyaunsht. Killing shot. Very good. As you can see, this tank is a very, very decent sniper schnitzel. It's definitely not bad. But one thing which is worth mentioning... I am playing the second battle with this tank, and if your team is just way better than enemy team is, you are not going to have a great performance. You are not going to have a great score, because if enemies are melting, and you are playing with Almighty Sniper, Schnitzel, Tank Destroyer, whatever, it's not going to be the most enjoyable gaming experience for you. Let's get real. Because since enemies are dying too fast, you simply... they're not making those mistakes which you want. And I'm not going to play another battle with this vehicle. We'll see how the things will go. I hope we can push it to 1000, but you never know. Anyways, we are relocating into the other position, right? And from here, I will try to snipe those people which is playing around this area. Hopefully, everything will go well. This guy is over there. I am trying to be safe from the sniper schnitzels over there. And it looks like we are feeling quite well. Look at this guy. He's thinking about peeking. Is he? He changed his mind. And now look, Ikeas is sniping from here. Enemy team is basically melting. The score is 7-2. Yeah, it's sad. But in the same time, fellas, this is the World of Tanks in 2019. This is the game which all of us, or majority of us, love. And unfortunately, but a lot of a lot of those unequal games is happening. And not much what we can do about that. It is, in my opinion, it is the reason of matchmaking and unbalanced tanks. If in every single battle we would have tiny touch more balanced tanks, let's say like that, more balanced tanks, and same class would fight against the same class, like sniper against the sniper, heavy tank against the heavy tank, it would be a tiny touch better. But hey, it is how it is, and this is definitely not today's topic, so let it be. 300 done so far, enemies is melting, and you know what? It's going to be a good showcase of all this. Why? Because not every single time you can have an amazing score with a sniper schnitzel vehicle. It is just how everything is working, and it's just the case, okay? So not every single time you are going to have amazing score, and you need to understand that, right? The best case scenario for this vehicle, in my opinion, is when your team is melting, right? But not completely, not like crazy melting. They are dying one by one, but battle is quite long. So enemies have some time to make mistakes, and then you can do the things properly. Other than that, no bueno and not good. And fellas, this Archer is not a terrible tank by any means. If I am not having the greatest score in this game, it doesn't mean this tank is terrible or something, right? It doesn't mean this tank is terrible. And now the funniest thing of all this. This IS is going to turn on us and he is going to kill us with one shot. Can I change it? Negative. I just simply cannot change it. Look. I was so lucky. Oh, he is using the different gun. Well, I'm going to be dead anyways now. But hey, once again, I am not complaining. I'm very, very happy man. This is the game with Archer, fellas. And obviously, I can try to play a couple of more battles with this vehicle. And then maybe we are going to have a better game. But once again, two games, when the teams is not very, very equal, when enemies are melting completely, when enemies are not making mistake, and the score is like this. And I'm going to leave it for now, okay? I am definitely not complaining, fellas. Everything is fine. Look, speaking of this tank, we managed to get only 600 damage, and the game which we had before, right, which I decided not to show, we had 600 damage and 400 assisting damage. Not much what you can do when, look, the score is like this. It's sad, but it is reality. Let's move to the other tank, fellas. And other tank is going to be a hill. Let me prepare this vehicle for battle, and we will start our journey in a sec. And fellas, it is about the time to play with a hill. This is the first time when I'm playing with a hill. Yes, it's definitely, we have this performance from very first time. Yes, fellas, life is beautiful, everything is fine. As you can see, all games is like 1000. Why so? Probably I'm not focusing on the game too much myself, because I know this tank is not bad by any means. I don't know what is happening. Maybe today it is not my day. Maybe it's Friday 13 or something. I don't know. But gaming experience is kind of ridiculous today, I must admit that, which is kind of sad thing, but not much what I can do about that, and I am simply accepting this, right? So we are not crying in the corner, we are taking our balls into the hand and we are holding them, and we will try to get maximum use of all this, okay? Sometimes things like this is happening, and usually when I am doing Tech 3 showcase, it's taking me one or two games to get with a tank, but today is not the same situation. Today is very, very, very complicated situation. But hey, sometimes things like this is happening, and once again, fellas, tank destroyers is tank destroyers as a class, it's asking for a lot of patience and red line sniping and everything. And if enemy team have no team, GG. If you have no team and all of them is dying very quickly, GG. And so on, so on. It's just, it's not looking very good. But we will cross our fingers and we will try to get maximum use of all this. At least I hope so. At least I hope so. And in the same time, I am kind of waiting till we are going to grind up the tiers, right? What exactly do I want to see? I want to see exactly tier 8, tier 10. Those two tanks is definitely a highlight of all this nation. Also, with all this tech tree. Also, fellas, if we are speaking about the grind, I would grind the tank, right? I would pick the medium line to grind through, okay? That's what I think, because with the medium tanks I had better gaming experience than with the tank destroyers. But once again, maybe I was unlucky and not much what I can do about that, right? Maybe. So, right here, I know it sounds quite funny, but I don't really like what I am seeing here. Unfortunately, the battle is heading here, and I think they have quite some forces in the city. We will try to punish this T-67. We are aiming quite well for him. It's definitely not a snapshot by us, and that second one supposed to be a hit. So let's hope we are going to deal with this guy if he's going to get spotted. Also, you know what is happening right here? This Oni, I want to believe this Oni is going to clear pretty much all our forces without even asking our forces' names, so keep that in mind. We managed to track this guy. Can we retrack him? I was aiming for those sweet tracks. Unfortunately, that was not the case. It's okay. Let it be. And you know what? Things is definitely not looking too good for us. I mean, we are losing city now. Yes, we are going to kill this Hellcat. Hip hip hooray, right? And this crew is definitely new crew, 100%. But in the same time, fellas, it's performing quite well. I mean, for sniping, this tank is definitely not the vehicle with which I could complain, right? If enemies are doing mistakes, if enemies are peeking on the open field or something, we can definitely punish them. I think the main problem of today, at least for me, maybe it is a weekend or something, and maybe one team is just way stronger than other. I don't know. Look at this. Well, let it be. I will keep this game as it is, and you will see the true colors of this thing, right? Once again, if I want to make like super duper hyper turbo epic games, I will never ever make the live battles, if I can say so. I will go what I would do, fellas, I would go to the VOD replays or whatever. I would pick a content from the other people which had amazing game, and then I would talk about how good this tank is, right? In the same time, don't get me wrong, this tank is not bad by any means. It is not bad, but it's not excellent, right? At least I don't see too much of the bad things about this vehicle, but maybe it is only me. Maybe it is only me. Anyways, we are trying to get quite some use of this cover 2, right? Cover 2 is taking one for the team. Yip, yip, hooray. And now enemies are pushing like super aggressively for us. But I'm not afraid. Everything is fine. We want to take those bushes over there and we will try to work them out. It's fine. Not the first time, not the last time, fellas. We got this. Obviously, we are not going to win this battle, but you know. We will try to get as much use as we can in this game. That's what we will try to do. In fact, I'm going with APCRs right here. I hope this guy did not spot me though. Apparently he didn't. Good, 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 good. Very good. Very good. This guy should not spot me either. Very nice. The question is, do I want to sit here and wait until I will get killed or what? What do I want to do? This is the main question of all this. You know what? Only pussies are thinking. We are just going and killing them. This guy is going to be dead meat in a second. Unfortunately, he outspotted us, which I cannot do anything about that. And I'm getting killed by the Oni, I assume. Yes, Oni one-shotted us. Okay, this is the game which we are having. This is the battles which we are having today. The fourth replay with this tank 1.3. You know what? I'm leaving this. And I am having quite terrible luck with this vehicle. Hopefully luck is going to change and hopefully we are going to have a better games in the future. Is it frustrating? Kind of, yes. It's not, I know what this tank is capable of, but with the current situation, with the current teams, it's just a joke, okay? And sometimes things like this is happening, but once again, fellas, you cannot change anything right here. So let it be. I'm accepting that kind of situation and better luck next time. So here you go, a hill game. I did everything properly in this battle. I was sniping, team lost the game. Not much what I can do about that. I was not top tier, so I could not go in front, you know, while yelling blah, 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 blah. So I am just accepting that, and I am obviously a top player of this game. Hip hip hooray, next tank. Let's prepare the challenger. Oh, actually challenger is prepared for game. We are going to play a couple of battles with this vehicle because there is a couple of guns to play with, okay? And both of the guns could be an option. One of the gun is 280 alpha damage, another of the gun is 150 alpha damage. Actually, you know what? Let's play one battle with a tier 7. I will play with a 280 alpha damage gun, and 150 alpha damage gun is the same like on a hill and on other tanks. So I believe one battle is going to be more than enough, right? Without further ado, let's click into the battle, and fingers crossed we are going to have a better gaming experience, because now it's crazy. I am doing this tech tree for like the third hour already, because I need to wait until the game will end and so on, so on. It's quite, it is quite sad, quite weird, and not really enjoyable, right? So, yeah, it's okay. So with a challenger, we have a corridor pass map, corridor, whatever. We will try to get some kind of use of all this, right? Funny fact, I don't have Lansen yet, so unfortunately I cannot give you content in time, but that was my fault. I did not ask it that in time, so I need to wait more until Wargaming is going to give that vehicle for me. But hey, what can I do? Not much. I'm just accepting that, right? I am just accepting that. Easy, fellas, easy. So, first of all, we are going to take this position over there and hopefully we can get a shot into the crossing forces. This guy managed to cross easily, but next guy which we are going to hit is going to be this guy. I hope this scout is not going to bump into us, however it's called. Yes, apparently it's not going to be the case. Blind shot over there, hopefully we hit him. LTTB spotted us, not much what we can change right here. It's just impossible for us to change here. Also, one thing which is definitely worth mentioning, I probably prefer this gun on this tank, but the thing is, look, this is the maximum how much you can turn, so keep that in mind. You don't have a full rotation with this vehicle, which is definitely the thing which is worth mentioning and the thing which I must tell you, right? In some situations it might be annoying when you don't have a full rotation, but this alpha damage is making some kind of difference, right? And I would probably go with this gun. Obviously there is different situations in the game when maybe a 150 alpha damage gun would work better if you want to perma-track someone and so on. But in the same time, hey, it is my preferential and that's what I prefer on this vehicle, right? And once again, this is how much you can turn. It is like, I don't even know, 150 degrees angle, maybe 140. It's not so good, right? It is not so good, but it is enough. At least I think it is enough for me, right? The question is, will some of the enemies will try to go like this? Currently we are losing this side, and in fact, fellas, our team is not the best, okay? We have some people which is sitting right here, which is afraid to move, and enemies have only a couple of forces here. But one or another way, it's just not worth to push like this, because this is ice road, which in my opinion is a waste. But hey, it's okay. Right now we are going to take this position over there, and hopefully from this position we are going to get some shots into the people which is going like this. Hopefully everything will go well, and I would love to see at least 2,500 in this battle, but we'll see. I am just hoping for the best, because even my hands are just going, you know, down from today gaming experience. But maybe I'm just unlucky, or maybe it is because of the weekend, or I don't even know why that kind of stuff could happen. Well, probably luck is the biggest highlight of all this. Sometimes it is your lucky day when you are killing everyone with a big smile on your face and you are just destroying them all. And sometimes it is not the luckiest day ever, right? This guy was not getting spotted and he took one for the team just because of me. That was kind of a dick move, but in the same time I did not meant to make him to take one for the team, if I can say so, right? Luckily our Oni is coming for a base death, and I am surprised this guy is doing that, okay? And by saying surprised, I mean surprised from the good way, okay? Definitely from the good way. One into the cover 85. Luckily he is not spotting us. Very, very good. We are going for another one. Maybe we are not going to get spotted because we was abusing the bush mechanics. We are not getting spotted. Once again, he is there. 2000. Yes, fellas, we are getting there. Look, we are doing everything properly right here, and game is treating us nice, and we are hitting our shots. Good, good, I told you. Maybe we had a terrible experience with the lower tiers, but with this tank we are working enemies out. Amazing, beautiful, excellent, bellissimo. Good, that's what I want to see, fellas. Very, 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 very nice. I'm happy. I know it looks quite weird, you know, after one okay-ish game skill is like happy or something, but you have no clue what kind of gaming experience I had before, okay? So please, give me a chance to enjoy myself at least once. Okay, Tiger 1 is trying to cross like this. We should get the shot into him over there. Unfortunately that was not the case, but it's fine. Now I'm just pushing like this, so all good. They lost this battle. And the weirdest thing of all this, how? This is the weirdest thing of all this. Actually, I cannot say they lost this battle yet. Why so? Because this Lorraine is going to take like very, very safe defense parameter over there, and he's going to be super annoying for us. Luckily, this guy is down to 2 shotable for us, so hopefully we could eliminate him from the game, right? And Lorraine, how much hit points Lorraine has? We will check it out in a second. Obviously low roll. What is the alpha damage? 280. Well, game is not treating that as that well as I expected, right? but it's fine. What is the penetration with a high explosive? 47. I think it's not worth to risk it for the biscuit for that, Lorraine. It's just simply not worth it. I'm just pushing now, but not with high explosives, right? Can I ram him? Can you help me a bit, fellas? Ram, 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 ram. Never mind. Never mind, okay? Good. Good battle. 3,500. 400. Good. 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 At least. Good game. Quite funny, right? I'm telling you, I needed a lot of games with the lower tiers to show you at least something okay-ish. So now I am feeling extremely good with this kind of situation when we are having a good time and when we are... and when we are getting enough use of all this, if I can say so, right? I am definitely feeling super good with it. Good! Ace Vanker, 3,800, 1.4 base experience. And this tank is good, fellas. Other tanks which I played is good too, but you know, everything is depending on the game and sometimes it's going very well and sometimes it's not going that well. But it's okay. That was the game with the Challenger. Would I be able to do the same thing like in this game with this kind of gun? Probably yes. And I would have tiny touch better DPM. Actually better on 200. But once again, sometimes alpha is important thing and you are not losing that much of the accuracy right there. At least I want to believe that. Well, this one is 0.3, this one is 0.35, but if you are aiming, your shots is hitting where you are aiming, which is important, right? Anyways, tier 9, tier 10, tier 8, tier 9, tier 10 left. Charioteer, the highlight of all this line, and this tank is insanely good. This tank is so good. In my opinion, this is keepable for majority of the people who is enjoying quite sneaky gameplay, because this tank have a very, very funny thing. First of all, let's check the gun. Gun is very, very interesting. 390 alpha damage in the tier 8, it's fine. Gold ammunition on this tank is 210 penetration gold, which is lower than a standard, but you can you are hitting more, right? And high explosives, 105 penetration, 480 hit. It's just beautiful. It's very, very good. Let's double check. Is the tank is top? Yes, tank is top. Okay, fellas. We can do this. Come on. We want to have a nice game. I don't care about matchmaking. I want to have a nice game for myself. Game, you are beautiful. Treat me well. It's Friday evening after all. Let's go. Let's do this. Very nice. Very, very nice. Minsk, I'm not panicking. Look how many tank destroyers do they have. Very good. We will try to get a lot of use of all this, so all good. Nice. Nice, fellas. Very, very, very good. I believe the best thing for us to do is to go somewhere over there and we will start probably the game from the blind shots around this area. As you can see, funny thing, but I don't have a standard high explosives into this tank. Why so? Because this is the same high explosives with a bigger alpha damage. Yes, it costs more. Yes, I don't care. I have 38 millions, okay? So I can, I believe I can afford that. Everything is fine. And for me, this tank is pretty much the closest tank for a Scorpion in the tech tree, right? At least that's what I think. You have fully rotatable turret, which is super, duper, hyper, turbo good. Everything is just ideal with that, and it's beautiful, if I can say so, right? So, everything is fine. Now, guys, let's take this position over there, right? Mods. I outspotted the mods and he did not spot me. Aha. Good. Let's go with the blind shots over there. IS-7 is crossing through the middle. Very, very interesting stuff. That was not a blind shot hit, by the way. I like to start this battle from the blind shots over there, okay? Usually it's working quite good and you can get some kind of use of all this. Obviously after the battle we will check it out. Can we, did we receive any blind shots or not? I think the last one did not hit because I saw some kind of splash there. Anyways, can we spot someone over there pretty please? Leo one over there, okay. Do we have any sniper schnitzels who could hit him? Apparently not. Very, very sad story. I'm kind of afraid for my father, for why it is a tier 10 tank in the same line, and I can tell you that. That tank can one-shot you. He can one-shot pretty much anything, so keep that in mind, right? Slowly. Fellas, very, very slowly. I am just trying to play over there, you know, to spot guys which is sitting right there. This is the most important part of all this so far. Obviously, this Vaka is kind of asking to take one for the team, but in the same time, I am a bit afraid of that guy, just a bit. Can we go for another blind shot over there? I think this could be a hit though. Should I go for another one? Yes, why not? I don't have anything to lose, or do I? I'm not sure, am I hitting someone over there or not? This is the thing. Come on. That was definitely not a hit. That was definitely not a hit. Maybe over there. The thing is, I cannot make pressure myself over there because it's going to be game over, like, immediately. So I just can't afford that, okay? If I'm going to go in front, it's going to be game over. Can I kill this guy, like, with auto-aim? There is only one way to figure that out. Auto-aim. Good, 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 good. Scorpion over there, Leo over there, yes, we are spotting them, life is beautiful. Apparently our team is winning this battle very, very easily. The question is, can we get enough use of all this? And this is the biggest question of all this, right? Scorpion is trying to escape, I want to believe. Did he spotted me? He didn't. You know what that means for a Scorpion? He's taking everything for the team and he's going down. Very good. Now we know where the trash burn is. Very nice. And we spotted trash burn, in fact. There is a Scorpion, but we are getting the sweet assisting damage. And we are loading high explosives right there. Why so? Because we can afford that. How about this guy's side, please, game? That was not a penetration, but I can't complain too much. I cannot cry too much about that. Maybe this guy, pretty please, game, let me... Ooh, boy, 500 in the face. Good game. It is not ideal, and I believe if I would try to play with this tank tiny touch more, couple of battles more, I would get twice or triple better score than this. But I am feeling extremely good with that. You know, I am not complaining and everything is looking quite fine for me. After those games which I had before, and before I had not so good games, this is looking like excellent battle, right? And we did pretty much everything properly in this game. We was playing quite safe at first. After that, we tried to spot, which we did properly, and in the end of the day we finished this with 1.7 and 1.7. Obviously, it is a tier 8 skill, you could do it better, and this is amazing tank. What do you mean you don't want to play one more game? How do you dare? Actually, I have one blind shot. And that blind shot was into the Leo, if I'm not mistaken. So 2.1, 1.7, close to 4,000 combined. I will accept that. And the biggest highlight which I have about this vehicle, and I'm not joking, this tank is like a Scorpion for me with a tiny touch even better gun. Yes, lower alpha damage, but in my opinion, Charioteer have amazing gun accuracy, in my opinion. It has amazing high explosives, and the best thing of all this, if you don't want to shoot gold, you don't need to, because you have amazing penetration with the standard rounds, which is working good in pretty much every single situation. 500 meter sniper schnitzel, 250 8 penetration in 500 meters. Shell velocity is good, and I'm telling you, fellas, it's one of the better tanks, so keep that in mind. And if you are enjoying the tank, I would highly recommend you to keep it. Just to keep it, and to have some fun, and to enjoy yourself. So that was the Charioteer. You know what? We will talk about the FV in a second. And I believe it is about the time, right? FV, Convoy. Two options of the guns. Option number one, big Derp gun. Option number two, DPM gun. We are going to play two games with each gun, and hopefully everything will go well, right? At least I want to believe everything will go well. In reality, you never know, fellas. Westfeld, quite some heavy tanks. Okay, so Derp gun. What is the thing with the Derp gun with this tank? You have 180 degrees of rotation. So you can rotate till this and you can rotate till this. With other gun, you have full rotation, so you can rotate the turret all the way around, plus you have better DPM. This gun, though, it has some beauty. I mean, you have 200 penetration, which is not super good, right? But actually, I'm going to go with a golden high explosives for lols, and if we will penetrate someone, we are going to have a laugh. Let it be. I believe we deserve a bit of fun, don't you think so? So, first of all, we are heading into the bushes over there. This is the right position where I want to be. And right there, fellas, we will wait until someone is going to peek like this, because usually someone is trying to look who is living over there. And since we are chilling in the double bush, well, far away from the bush, we cannot spot for ourselves, but we can't get spotted either. So, so that's what we are doing. By the way, we hit him for 76, which sounds quite funny and not much, but we did a 3 critical hit. So this Emil is a bit mad on us. I can tell you that. Can we? Unfortunately, no. Well, that's what you are getting with a Derp gun. Sometimes Derp guns can treat you like a king or like a queen, depends who you are. And sometimes Derp guns can treat you like a piece of kaku. Once again, everything is depending on the RNG, on the treatment and everything, right? We are just not hitting anything. Well, it's fine, I'm not complaining. Better luck next time. I believe we are going to have at least a couple of the penetrations, which is going to be beautiful. And fellas, if you are not willing to troll with this tank, if you are not willing to spam like gold ammunition with it, which is high explosives, I would highly recommend to go for... I would highly recommend to go for the other gun, because other gun have way better penetration and you simply can have better experience, at least in my opinion. Once again, it is only me, oh my. But those hits for 750 with a high explosives and bunch of critical hits, you must admit, they are enjoyable, they are very fun. And even though if you are not penetrating, you are hitting people for some damage anyways, and it doesn't matter you are pinning or you are not pinning, right? At least this is the logic which I have, because I don't really care I am penetrating or I am not penetrating. If I can have, oh my, I could aim better, I'm accepting my responsibility, I could aim better. I was so excited, that was the side of the T-54, so it's fine. The new premium tank, you know what is the best thing of all this? He doesn't have, he simply doesn't have armor. I was waiting until this T-54 is going to peak, but unfortunately this is not the case. We need to repush. Why do we need to push on them right now? Because once again they have, they simply have no team, and look what is happening in the other side. Other side is just going on the full. So we need to start doing something, otherwise it's going to be too late. I believe we could call this gun a meme gun, right? When you are penetrating someone, you can laugh, you can smile, and you can ask, did it feel good though, and so on. But if you are not penetrating, if you are not hitting, then it's hashtag never lucky, and then it's not too enjoyable of the thing, right? And plus it costs a lot. The other gun, which I'm going to show you in a second, is going to be a completely different story, right? With other gun, you will have way better aim time and way better everything, right? But it feels so good. But with other gun, if you might need to go into the gold from time to time if you are dealing against the Type 5 heavy or something, and you don't have those high explosives, you have a different ones, and we are going to talk about that in a second. Definitely not the best battle with a convoy, and I could repeat it, but I will not repeat that. I will play another game with another gun, and hopefully we are going to have a better gaming experience, and hopefully everything will go well, right? One or another way, this is it. We try to punish enemies for their stupidity, we punish them. 2.6, let's get real, it's not the best score ever, but we were sniping, and that's the score which we managed to get, 2.6. Definitely not the best score whatsoever, but once again, I am feeling good with it. I am not complaining, I am feeling happy. Next, another gun. This gun is DPM gun. It is a sniper schnitzel gun. This is the loadout which I have 17, 10 and 8, because this time have a decent high explosives apparently. I forgot that. I haven't played with it for a while. So we'll see how this gun is going to treat us, right? We have a decent view range with this tank destroyer, so we'll see. Also, I am quite excited about the trash burn games, because I want to play two or three battles with the trash burn, and there are some people which is yelling about the trash burn. Once again, fellas, I'm reading comments. There are some people which is yelling about the trash burn like it's overpowered. A tank, it can one-shot you. Yes, it can. But everything rest on the tank is just pure pile of shit. I believe we are going to have a bad game with that tank, and hopefully we are going to have a good game too. So, you will see how everything is looking like with that vehicle, right? You never know. You never know, fellas. Anyways, this gun have a penetration of 259, which is okay. APCRs is 326, very good. And high explosives is 120, very good. So basically, if you want to deal with Borshik, I don't even know, Leopard, Batshat, or other tanks like this, you can actually penetrate them with the high explosives, which is very, very great help. Obviously, with the other gun, you could do that too with the golden high explosives, right? So, everything is completely depending on you and on your preferential. I don't really think you could go wrong with this vehicle, to be completely honest with you. I think everything with this vehicle, right, is completely depending on your preferential. If you want to troll around with a derp gun, go and do this. Go and play with a derp gun and troll around and smile while doing so. If you prefer to have more accurate gun, the gun which you could trust more and so on, then simply pick this one. For me, probably it depends on the mood. Sometimes I would play with one gun, sometimes I would play with other gun, and one or another way I would be happy with any of those. Is it my favorite tank? Would I give this tank banana out of 10? No. It never ever was my favorite tank, and I don't really think it will ever be my favorite tank, okay? But it's okay. It is okay. Yeah, Centurion is going like this. I need to figure out what is happening, because we don't have too many forces. We don't have too many forces in the city, and I believe that makes sense, right? Look at the DPM of this tank. Look. We just blind shot him, by the way, and now we are shooting the other guy. He lost his engine or something. I don't even know what this person is doing. Well, it doesn't matter. He's dead already. So with this tank, if I'm not mistaken, this gun is a tortoise gun, right? If I'm not mistaken. I mean, that was beautiful shot to this T100 light. That was beautiful, beautiful shot for sure. And plus, the best thing about this tank, with this gun, you can fully rotate your turret, which in some situations it can be kind of awkward when you cannot do that, right? So with this gun preferential, you are not going to have that kind of problems, if it's the most important thing for you, right? Because I know some people hate turrets which is not moving fully, and I completely understand those people. Anyways, what we are going to do now, we are going to join the city. I am kind of surprised Trashburn is not playing in the city, but it is that guy preferential and it is that guy problem. Right there, guys, we are going to make a hardcore pressure with our Jack Pizda fast. Let's go together. Disgustingly good accuracy, I'm telling you. This is good thing. I like this time. It's not my favorite, don't get me wrong, but I can play with it and I can have a decent performance with this vehicle. He just shot. You know what that basically means? He's saying, could you kill me? Yes, I can. This gun is treating us very, very, very well. What we are going to do now, we will start working this Panzer. Bounce to the side, 350 alpha damage, 400 by the way. There is plenty of low rolls, but I am not complaining about that. Sometimes RNG is treating you in very good ways, sometimes it is treating you in the bad way, so you are getting plenty of the low rolls, but this is not the thing about which I could complain too much. I'm loading high explosives and there is one reason. Do you see this guy? He's asking for me to do that. Look. Look into this person. Look into his eyes. Look into his eyes. He is looking at me. I'm looking at him. Both of us are happy. Ram death. Beautiful. Just simply beautiful. Wafflecock, I have high explosives for you. Could you please wait for me? I am coming. As you can see, this gun is a bit different story, right? With this gun, you have tiny touch better. You are not that relied on the situations, right? Sometimes, in other words, sometimes you can wait, good. Sometimes you can have amazing score with this gun, sometimes you can have a bad score with this gun. Let's see. I am quite curious, did we penetrate this guy with a blind shot or not? We definitely penetrated, but he is stunned, so maybe it could be an Arta. Definitely not the penetration, but I am not complaining, and I'm simply waiting till that Arta is going to get spotted. Arta is spotted, nothing what we could do. It's okay. Five kills, 4,000 damage. Soon we will figure out did we hit some blind shots or not. I am very, very, very excited and I'm very happy with this game. It was definitely, we did everything properly, and I hope I showed you the both case scenario with a gun, right? 4.6 damage. I hope I showed you both case scenarios with the guns, right? This one is more competitive in my opinion. It's not that derpy as a gun, and you have very solid DPM with it. And with other gun, you need to rely on some kind of luck and on everything. DPM of this tank is 3000. Obviously, with our things and everything, it's 3,800, which is crazy. If we are speaking about this this DPM, if you are shooting APs, it's only 3,100. So, quick information once again. I want to repeat the same thing, so I hope every single of you will understand what I meant to say, right? If you want to troll around with a gold high explosives, go for this gun, everything is fine. If you don't want to troll around with a high explosives, go for this gun. Easy peasy, just like this. It depends on you, my lovely friend. So, easy. And now, fellas, the most exciting part of all this. Fava, stage 2, 2 or 3 games, depends on the games. I'm not going to do any cuts whatsoever. When we will start our gaming experience with this vehicle, keep that in mind. I have improved equipment right there, so this is also very important thing, and it's worth to mention. Give me a second and we are going to start. And we are about to start the game. So, what is loadout? What is the right loadout? I am using 15 gold and only 5 APs. Actually, I could even make 3 APs and 17 high explosives. Why so? Because I think this is the right way. This tank is created to shoot with the high explosives. And one of the most important things about this vehicle, right, fellas, is a lot of I have seen some people which is very complaining about this tank. This tank is overpowered, this tank can one shot you. Yes, you are absolutely right about that. This tank can one shot you and everything. But fellas, this vehicle is extremely hard to play. You don't have camo, you don't have armor, you don't have speed, you don't have fully rotatable turret. There is a trollish factor in this tank. This is the tank which you are playing when you want to have a good mood, when you want to enjoy yourself and you want to ruin someone's game. Like twice a day, three times a day, not more than that. At least this is my opinion, right? I believe there is some people which is saying this tank is the best tank in the world of tanks and I love this tank the most. Probably. There are some people which is thinking so. I'm not one of them. Also, how we are going to start this battle, I hate to push this side, so I'm not going to do that. And it is about the time to blind shot this bush over there, right? If we are going to blind fire someone, more likely we you are going to see the killing shot right there. So let's start our journey. One over there. It's okay, I have 3 APs and I'm going to use those 3 APs for a blind shots. Why? Why not to do so? They don't have too many hit points anyway, so I believe it's the best thing to do. Also, this guy really doubt he spotted me since I am sitting in the huge bad bush, so why not? Also, this guy is not having the best time in his life. But it is his problem. T92, where are you? The question is where that T92 is sitting. Is he sitting in this bush or he is not sitting in this bush? This is the biggest question of all this. I hope this guy is not going to make me to take one for the team, right? I hope so. Also, fellas, one of the most important things over there is I am waiting till the enemies will start making some kind of pressure towards us, okay? I am waiting exactly that moment. Then we will start shining with this vehicle. Anyways, the last blind shot right over there, okay? Can we? As you can see, we did not manage to hit any blinds. And it's quite funny when you are playing with this vehicle, you are hitting a blind shot and you immediately know did you hit that or not, so... It is definitely one of those good things with this tank, right? Oh boy, stay. I'm kind of ashamed that was not penetration, but sometimes things like this is happening. So, no complaints, no regrets, all good. Do I think you can play aggressively with this tank? Definitely. I think you can play aggressively with this tank too. All the time, no, but from time to time, yes, you can definitely do that. All those guys are dead, they decide to make a pressure and it's bad for them. But soon everything is going to flip around. What do I mean by saying it's going to flip around? I mean, when our guys is going to die over there, let's get real, I cannot make a pressure and I cannot help them. They will start peeking like this. If they will start peeking like this, they are going to take one for the team and it's going to be pretty much game over for them. I want to see this guy. 2, 1. And unfortunately we are not hitting him. Damn it. Well, that's what you are getting with this tank. It's very, very good reality check, and for those people, you know, which is thinking it's the best and most overpowered tank. No, it's not. Yes, it's extremely fun to one-shot someone and to have a good time when someone is making mistake and GG finito. But if it's not the case, if enemies are not making mistake, it is not that good as you might think it is. This is definitely the highlight of all this. I made kind of a mistake from because I effed off from that position where I was, right? And this guy is not going to win this side, so I'm going back. I don't really want to lose any damage right there. Any hit points, that's what I meant to say. Mi scusi. Okay, Jack Tiger still have hit points. So what we are doing? Piri, 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 piri. We are heading into the same bush where we were sitting for pretty much whole battle. I hope this guy did not spot me, even though he could. He definitely could. But he didn't. Good. And this Jack Tiger. Look at this beauty. Come on. Game. Please. Treat me well, game. Please treat me well. Actually, I'm relocating tiny bit right there. Just to find a shot on that Jack Tiger, because he's looking so sweet, he's looking like a candy, okay? Come on. Relocating tiny touch right here, not too much, just a bit. And now we are waiting for that beautiful moment when person is making mistake, he is going to pay a full price for his stupidity. I hope our Jack Tiger is going to F off from here though, because it's kind of bad. This guy is dead. One of the most important things with this tank, you don't really need to aim to do damage. This is definitely one of those things, definitely one of those highlights about this vehicle, right? That's for sure. Unfortunately, our guys is dealing with everyone over there, so I am accepting that. So for those people which is saying, but this tank is overpowered, you can one-shot every single vehicle in the game and so on. As you can see, it's not that easy, because in city map, I agree, you can make a pressure, you can go through the street, through the corner, and then you can punish someone. In open map, more likely you are going to be the one which is going to take one for the team, okay? So, keep that in mind. I cannot spot that Borshek. He have way too good camo for me to spot him, so it's kind of sad. This is kind of disgusting first game, I must admit that. Am I feeling very happy with it? No, definitely no. But in the same time, I kind of deserved this. I did not play this battle very, very well, and it's fine. I'm not going to cut this battle out of the YouTube video. I want you to see everything. I want you to see a reality, how the things are looking like and what you can expect with this vehicle. Sometimes it's going to be insanely good, sometimes it's going to be insanely bad. For example, in this certain situation, right, enemies did not make mistakes for us to punish them. RIP. And that's it, finito. What do you expect more? I would love to see Arta hitting me. Arta, could you hit me? I want that Arta to hit me. I'm doing this on purpose. I want to show you what is happening when Clicker is hitting this tank, and it's not a joke. So, you know, it is not a joke. Should I go? I tried. I must go with the blind shots. And I believe it's completely understandable why am I doing this. Okay, listen. The first of all, why I was not heading for... Ooh, boy. Why I was not heading for this position, first of all? Because they had two lights, and usually there is quite a big chance light is going into this bush or into this bush and you are getting outspotted. So it was just not a good idea for me, right? Not with a trash burn. If I would have camo and I would not, I would have tiny lower profile, it would be way better. This tank is nothing about that. And here you go, fellas. Overpowered tank, 900 damage, 100 assisting damage. I tried to do everything what I could in this battle. It was simply not the case, and that kind of things is happening. And in fact, when people is asking, is it my favorite tank destroyer? Its answer is no. Why? Because it's not consistent. Sometimes it is very good, sometimes it's very bad. Usually for me, I am having games like average 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, but nothing more than that. Obviously, I have done some, if we are checking the damage record on this tank, 9,800, obviously it's possible, but in the same time, it is very, very complicated, right? Let's go, once again, trash burn, here we go. What we are going to do now, I want to believe we are going for a heavy line, because I want to... smack the heavy tank. We'll see. Okay, we'll see, boys. I think the heavy line would be the best thing. Actually, they have some sniper schnitzels. No, I changed my mind. I'm not going to go into the heavy line because I'm kind of afraid. Call me pussy, you can do that, it's fine. I'm going to take this position over there, and I hope our lights are going to spot people around this area or alternatively over there. If they are going to spot them, we are going to one-shot them. I want to do... we'll see how many battles we are going to play. If this battle is going to be insanely good, we will play two games. If this battle is going to be bad, we will play three games with this tank. So, we'll see. Right there, we are waiting until someone is going to get spotted. Because usually, let's get real. Usually, they have some people over there, right? Could I go with the blind shots over there? Definitely, I could, but I'm not going to do that. Or am I? I did not have a premium shot here. It is my fault. It's fine. Take it easy. Life is beautiful. Everything is fine. I'm just waiting until they will make a crucial mistake, because usually it is happening. Usually it is happening. That Jet Panther should pick once again. I think he pretended he is running out of here, but in reality he should be around this area. At least that's what I want to believe and that's what I am hoping for. With this tank, at least... I don't like to play aggressively. I want to say that straight. I don't like to play aggressively with this tank. Mistakes with this vehicle is definitely not forgiven at all, which is completely understandable. If this tank would have armor, it would be completely broken, and so on, so on. At least that's what I think. Obviously, this tank could work extremely well in like Himmelsdorf streets, right? In the Himmelsdorf streets, you can pick wherever you want, and you can have a very, very decent play, if I can say so. But we'll see. Sheridan is over there, and I believe they have many, many sniper schnitzels over there. I would love to see at least one of them and just simply kiss him. And, you know, that would be lovely, but it's not that simple as you might think, okay? Hmm. I just replied them to the Twitch chat because I'm late for a streaming, right? Everyone is yelling, skill is not there, skill is not there. I said, shut the fuck up. Whee! So it's fine. It's okay, boys, it's okay. I want to push. I want to make a pressure. Yes, you. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. This is the tank which I know, right? The trash burn, fellas, the trash burn can punish people for their mistake, right? For example, this person made a mistake, he got punished pretty much immediately. End of the story. End of the story. Scorpion over there. Can we one-shot him? Rush. I was trying to deal with that guy. Unfortunately, hashtag never lucky. Better luck next time, right? Now look, apparently this Asterva have a good angles to shoot them, so maybe we could get Tiny Touch closer right here and maybe we could get a better shots. Apparently this object got spotted. Can we find a shot into this guy? Definitely not. Okay, roger that. Everything is fine. What we are going to do now, it is about the time to move Tiny Touch more aggressively over there and maybe we can retake this side. Jack Tiger is next our target, okay? If Jack Tiger is going down, he will die. If Jack Tiger is not going down, he is not going to die. He might shit his pants. Unfortunately not. Well, what can you do? Oh boys, oh boys, oh boys. Oh boys. Hello, sunshine. I missed. It's fine. I'm not complaining. Everything is good. This guy is coming for us. He's thinking life is beautiful. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Life is definitely beautiful. Smile, my friend. You know, I can penetrate you right here. Yes, yes, yes. Spam me with that hit. Hit T-54. Just spam me. Your last word. I love Russia. He said. Well. Good for him, I guess. Good for him. 3,300. This is pretty much average battle for me with this vehicle. And once again, sometimes the things are working extremely good with this vehicle. And sometimes the things are working extremely bad with this vehicle. It did not change the situation for us since we was down to the one shot anyways, right? Can we see this object over there? If I'm no. Okay, my dream is to hit this guy, to one-shot this guy, to smile. Come on, I still can find a shot on him. You can do this, skill. You can do this. You can do this. Yes, skill, yes. He's tracked. You can do this. No. Bad aim. If I would complain the RNG or something, I would be a silly monkey. Since I am not silly monkey, I am feeling good. I missed that shot, that was my responsibility. I am crying in the corner and that was my fault. Damn it. Damn it, I played this game like a fool. Let it be. Trashburn, fellas, is not the easiest tank to play in the World of Tanks, and for those people which is thinking, but it's overpowered and no, simply no, it's not. You need to have many battles in order to have one like super respectable game when you have 7, 8, 9,000 whatever, right? And I am, at least this is my opinion. Obviously there is some people which is extremely good with this vehicle and which is enjoying that time with all their heart and which is playing very, very well with it. I'm not one of them. This is not my type of tank. My type of tank is light tanks, medium tanks, autoloaders, auto reloaders. Yes, give me those, I will play good. This tank, it's not for me. One or another way, it was fine battle, and we are going to finish everything with one more game because I want to hit at least 5,000. Come on. Oh my bananas. What the effing F you want? Blind shots. Blind shots. Okay, boys. Cross your fingers for me, okay? What we are going to do, we are going to go somewhere around this area and I will blind fire this bush. I can blind fire this bush. I can blind fire wherever I want to. So it's going to be quite interesting gaming experience. But hey, Artas, I know. What can I do? We'll see. Obviously, I'm going to be a priority target for Arta, and there is no doubts about that. I'm pretty sure about this. I am pretty sure about this. But let it be. Okay, let's go. First of all, our EBR spotted couple of guys over there. Do I want to pick like this? Do I want to take a huge risk for small award? Do I want to do that skill? Think about it. Do you want to do that huge, stupid risk just to one-shot someone?
Oh,
hell yes, Grilla.
Yeah.
Tell us what, Grilla. No! Well, not much what we can do about this. MC Drive subbed, even though he knows I am not streaming now. Wait a second. You are on video. Congrats. Anyways, can we? Can we? Fuck it. Well, I knew it. I'm aware of that. Everything is fine. I'm not focusing too much on the game. This is definitely not helping for us, but let it be. I'm accepting that. This scorpion is going to die. I think I know where he is. And he went tiny touch more aggressive over there, right? If I'm not mistaken, scorpion should be in those bushes over there. Yes, I am afraid of the Arthas. Yes, I am definitely paranoid by the Arthas. Can I change it? No, I cannot. This is the worst thing of all this, right? And we don't have the hill. And this is annoying. And that scout is doing a great job while trying to spot our forces over there. And this is no bueno. And not much what we can do about that. But hey, I'm not complaining. Let it be. Let it be. I'm kind of surprised how Arta did not shoot me and he shot that guy instead. But let it be. Maybe he missed. Maybe he missed me or something, right? Okay, uno momento, fellas. Uno momento. First of all, blind shot over there. Boom. Probably not a hit. It's fine. I have all time in the world of tanks. Relax, take it easy, fellas. I'm feeling great. I want to have at least 3 one shots in this battle and 1 blind shot. Okay. Blind shot achieved. Good. Very good. So, 3 one shots left. I knew where that scorpion was. He hit me before, so. Object. This is a big problem. This object could spot me all the time. This is actually a big problem. And they are making like hardcore pressure towards the... Ay-ay-ay, where is the RNG when we need that? They are making hardcore pressure through this. I'm not sure how I could deal with that, you know? This is the biggest problem and I'm definitely afraid because of the Arthas and everything. Hmm. Serbian badass is taking one in the ass. Feels good, man. That was one of the most important shots of this game. I'm not even joking. That was one of the most important shots of this game. Now we can start doing our things. Art is trying to escape. No one cares about the art though. Can I snap this Leo? If I could snap this Leo, I would be so damn happy. Wait. We can do this. Yes, 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 yes. Slowly but surely. Yeah. That was bad shot by me. No complaints, no regrets. Everything is fine. The thing is, in the open map, it is insanely hard to play with this vehicle. And I'm not joking. It is actually insanely hard to play with it just because this vehicle have no camo whatsoever. Gun accuracy is RNG dependent, and the best thing probably about this tank is those sweet blind shots. When you are hitting someone with a blind shot, you are laughing. Other than that, it's okay. How about the blind fire over there? Now I'm trying to figure out where exactly this Lancer C is, right? Because he could be in this bush, or he can be in those bushes here, or he can be in between. But first of all, give me a second. Let me deal with this VK. Maybe this VK will get spotted first. Indeed, he will get spotted first. Can I hit him with a blind hit? Definitely not a blind hit. Damn it. Well, as you can see, for those people which is saying, but trash burn is overpowered, here you go, in your face, fellas. Trash burn is tank which is extremely dependent on the RNG. Trash burn is the tank which could be extremely funny. Trash burn is the tank which can troll you a lot, and then you are going to cry in the corner. So it is, if I can say so, it is completely up to the RNG if we are speaking about this vehicle. And you can get penetrated by VK with a high explosives. Easy peasy, just like this. It's okay. I am done. That was a FV Tech 3 showcase. I hope I showed you everything what I could. Obviously, with the FV, we did not had a better game. It's very, very sad. Not much what I can do about this, and probably I throw it this battle. But fellas, let it be. I'm just accepting that. You have no clue what is happening in the chat right now, because I supposed to start the stream like 1 hour ago, but this Tech 3 showcase officially took approximately 4.5 hours, so that's how much it took, maybe even 5 hours. Anyways, it is how it is. No complaints, no regrets. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. We had at least one blind shot on the Scorpion here, so I am feeling good. Thank you. See you next time. Skill is out. Peace.